Just an opening for each bay where something can fly in and fly out. The magical time teleportation thing is getting old. Stop teleporting me through time. Thank you very much, ARK gods. What the crap? So. Hey there, folks. Mazion reporting for duty, and today we're playing ARK Survival Evolved on the Pooping Evolved Scorched Poop modded server. And today we're gonna do a base build. We're gonna build the base today. I'm not sure how much of it we're gonna get done. Hopefully, a lot. I have been gathering and making things, and I've moved all of my stuff over there except for this bench because it's got all kinds of crap in it. So as soon as I get all of this crap expended, we're gonna move. But I'm grabbing up some parts right now that I want to work with. Bam, bam, bam. I only need about that many, I think, of those. Then we're going to need some of these sloped ceilings. Where are you, sloped ceilings? What the crap? Where'd they go? They're not. No, they're there. And then we're going to go ahead and make a little bit of a start. Get a little bit of a start here. Let me see. Adobe ceilings and all right. So we should be good. I think we should be good to get a little bit of a start, because what I want to do here is on the in the middle here, it's five wide. I want to have a doorway. So I want to have a doorway starting about I think I want it here, but in the other direction. So I think I want it. I guess I want it on the inside. The inside track there. And then so on each side of this, I want to have some ceilings coming down. And so in order to do so, we need to use these right and left slanty things here. And it should be, I think. You see that how it's got extra snap points? Is it on the second one? We don't want it to snap. Weird. Weird, man. Yes. Want it to snap on the top one. There we go. Like that. And I think that's gonna do it there. I think. No, that's exactly not what we gotta do. We need to move this back. Bam. So what I'm trying to do here, hopefully I can get this one to snap right too. Oh, that one will snap right automatically because it does not have these walls below it. So I'm trying to do here is have a couple of walkways on the right and left-hand side of this thing. Yeah? Interesting. All right, let's have a look. Yep, that's what I want right there. Needs to be like that. And on the opposite side, same thing. Boom. And then I think right back here, we're going to have a doorway. I am a little ways in, so make sure it snaps right. All right, just like that. And then I'm gonna have slanted roofs that are gonna be a ramp up to an upper area on the outside here. Just what? Huh? What's with that? Why can't I walk through roofs? You know what? It must be the S plus stuff. That's weird, man. That's weird. So why would I want to be able to walk through that? Oh, I can't even select it. What the crap is going on here? Look at this. There. What the crap is going on? This is weird, man. It's not a structure. Something's wrong with the S plus sloped roofs. We're gonna have to use regular sloped roofs. Man, that's weird. I need to make myself a construction hat. So I'm gonna figure out how to get rid of these and make myself a construction hat. And then we're gonna come back. I'm actually gonna finish up this idea, but you see what I've got going here. I'm gonna go ahead and have ramps on either side, and then there'll be a compartment in the center-ish to come into the main building. And then we're gonna have some flyer locations up here on the top. But you gotta figure out. I gotta figure out why I can't do anything to these. You see, there's no E. I can't select them or do anything. So I'm wondering what I mean, I guess I'm gonna get rid of, maybe they'll float forever. What the crap is going on? Well, that one's obvious. They're obviously connected, but check this out, man. I'll let you guys hang out. Figure out what's going on here. Oh man. That is awfully strange. Okay, now they're just floating. Now they're just floating with no foundation, no connecting point. All right, so I'm gonna have to figure out a way to get rid of these things. And I'll be right back. I got this thing fixed up. So there, the ceilings that are floating are still here. They're still there. I just placed regular ones over them. I couldn't get rid of them no matter what I did. I tried everything. Even admin commands cannot get rid of them. Nothing can get rid of them. So they were not gotten rid of at all. And then, so you see this one here. I actually was trying to place a ramp here and could not, or rather I did not. I accidentally placed myself a ceiling, and then I could place a ramp right over it, and it didn't even destroy the ceiling. And that's the same case as what happened here. But this is the idea that I had. I wanted to have an area that you could go up and down with. Yeah. You know, I could even walk the bird. Oh, crap. I'm flying. I don't want to be flying. I could even walk the bird up and down it if I wanted to. Just walk right up. So this is what I wanted to have, and I'm not exactly sure where this is all going. That was weird. I could see through that from up there. That was weird. But this is kind of the idea that I had. I wanted it to be like this. So I'm going to place some more. Oh, crap. And I brought all of my things over on Mazion's Argentavis. So I've got all of my, oh crap, I didn't really think about how many things I'd have to scroll through. I brought all the ceilings and whatnot over here. So we're gonna extend the floor here. Now the floor doesn't seem to need any structures for the S plus, which is, when I say structures, I mean foundations or pillars or anything like that. You can just build right out there. So I'm thinking probably over here, we're gonna have some walls, which I don't have on me. So I'm gonna probably make this a box, like square these off. And I'm just gonna continue out here a ways. And I'm gonna put pillars on the underside for sure. Broken! All right, so this is a pretty big room for the first room here. And I'm trying to decide if I'm gonna have multiple rooms or not as we go up there. But what I gotta do here, I don't think, oh, I can. So I'm going to place the ceilings for the first platformed area up here. And I think I'm going to have multiples so that we can have, you know, more landing spots for different kinds of dinos, the wyvern, and I'll probably end up getting a power wyvern here at some point, and some other stuff. And I'm not sure, I might make a barn over there on that other side with some more kind of flyer spots. But usually with my main building, I just want to have spots for a couple of my favorite dinos that I use all the time. So that's what we're going to do up here. And I need more ceilings. Oh, man. Give them, get, scroll, ceilings. Okay, cool. I hope I made enough of everything, man. At least I have the ability to make so much more. It's not even a problem. So we definitely want to have an area up here for flyers. Now, what else would we possibly want up on a roof? I do not know. I'm kind of thinking that with all this stuff out here, I don't really have a need to have crafting stuff inside, but I still want to. So what I was thinking was like, you know, you want to work sometimes when it's in the sandstorm, you don't feel like being out in the sandstorm. And so I could, you know, put another fab and stuff in here. I wouldn't need like the epic forge, and I wouldn't need the chemistry bench and stuff like that, but I could have a fab, and I could have a smithy and S plus crafting station and stuff like that on the inside as well. So I'm kind of thinking like, what am I going to do? And I'm going to do something different off of the end here. But so what I'm going to do right now is I'm going to take a few minutes and I'm going to kind of make a plan on what I'm going to have on the very end of this little thing. I'm almost thinking like multi-tiered dino station or something. So like main area up here, and then, you know, main landing area up here, and then inside some decorations and and bookshelves and stuff like that to house some of the stuff that I'm gonna have. And then when we get over here, we'll have like a multi-tiered like tower at the end that might have like a couple of different places to fly in or something. That might be pretty cool. I'm gonna check it out. Let's do it. So I was out getting some wood here, and I got startled by this weird golden thingy that obviously has just been added to the game. It's a female alpha terror bird. It's like all gold, and it's level 392. I mean, it could be another base defender. I think we should definitely tame it up. Hopefully, you don't have to have golden treats to tame it. Gonna eat the meat? It's gonna eat the meat. So pretty soon, we're gonna have this ballerifically golden terror bird that's an alpha, apparently. I don't know. Golden beak. Like Golden Eye. Or Austin Powers Gold Member. Only Golden Beak. I don't know, man. I just tamed it. I didn't really need it. I just needed more material. So I'm gonna kinda talk to you about what we're doing with the build right here real quick. Hey, what's up, Golden Beak? You can just hang out in here, do all the things you need to do. I can stop being camo, that'd be amazing. Thank you so much. So I've decided to go with a stairwell in between here. So if you go up top here, there's gonna be a doorway. Oh, server saved? Probably. There's gonna be a doorway here. And then I'm either gonna segregate the stairwell off entirely or not. But these stairs are great because they build up one wall per piece and they snap together. So I made this little stairwell to go up three levels. And I'm thinking it might be three levels for now. We might build up to four at some point here. So then we'll have all these bays for flyers to come in. And maybe actually the top two will be flyer bays and then the bottom one will be something else entirely. What the crap is going on? Stop doing that. Someone's messing with my mind. Can I? Thank you. All right, so we're downstairs here. But as you can see, this is quickly going to be able to have like another level. What the crap? I have no idea what's happening right now. Oh, someone help me. So we could quickly have like some sort of ground level under here as well. So I need to figure out what I'm going to do for doorways for these. It might not actually have doorways. They might just have like an opening that you can fly into, because if I wanted to use like a regular dino gate, it probably wouldn't work. I could use like one big behemoth gate that covers the front, but I don't really want that either. So I'm thinking like just an opening for each bay where something can fly in and fly out. The magical time teleportation thing is getting old. Stop teleporting me through time. Thank you very much, ARK gods. What the crap? So hopefully this doesn't keep happening. I'm probably going to re-log because I have no idea what's going on. And it's really, really frustrating. So I'm going to maybe, you know, what could be happening is if someone's like harvesting with an Anki or something online here. Or like if Medialock's harvesting with something, it could be that he's locking up the server with the amount of resources that are being gathered. But anyway, so this is what I got going on here. We've got the inside going. This is going to be the main level, the main floor. I might do like a little lofty thing on one side or the other. I'm not really sure. And then we've got this whole thing in here where we're going to have, you know, different dino levels and dino bays. So what the crap is happening? I have no idea what's going on. Holy moly. I need to figure out what's going on. And then we'll discuss where the bedroom's going to be. It's time for an update, so I have gotten some work done here. Oh man, look at it, it's coming together, we're getting something done. And so on the end there, we're still working on some walls, and I've got some issues, and I obviously can see a couple right there. One is that one doesn't have a ceiling, but you can see there's a space between these two walls here, and I'm gonna show you a little bit about that when we go in. So inside here is the main room, and I was trying to think about like how I wanted to do my bedroom. And so I was kind of thinking that I would do like a little raised area, maybe in the center here, or maybe on one of these corners that's just like a raised up area with a bed and like, I don't know, I wish we had nightstands. I put a nightstand there or something like that. But I'm not sure which side I'm going to do it on. Probably over here, or like I said, somewhere in like the center. And then like around the outsides here would be all crafting type things and storage. And so out here you come out and you've got your first little dino bay here. And if we go upstairs here, upstairs, then we've got the second little bay. And then so if we, actually, yeah, what I want to show you is down in here. Bam. So you can see, if you look on this wall, at the bottom of the top wall, you can see on the left, there's something different than on the right. Now, what it is that these are snapped to each other, to the wall. And this one is snapped to the ceiling up there. So there's actually, on these ones are snapped to the bottom wall. There might be a gap or might not. But we need to make it uniform in one way or another. Now, I can't really, like, go up there and fly up to make sure that we're not having any gaps. It looks like there's no gap no matter which way you do it, except for the gap you can see right there between those walls. So I got to fix all that up. It's kind of a pain in the butt. And it happens a lot over here, too, when you have walls that are under. Like where these walls were, it was a wicked big pain in the butt. I had to fix it over in that main room many, many times. So if you're going to do something like this, when you want to put a skirt down below, make sure that you finish the upper part first so you don't have to worry about that crap. Now, I'm not actually sure why that one isn't snapped properly, but it's something that I'm going to address. And I've got this outside deck area. I'll probably put my grill out here and my industrial cooker, that kind of stuff. That's, I always like to have like a little patio porch thing where I do my food cooking. Like that's what I like in real life, you know, like have like a back porch, like on the lake with, you know, your grill and whatnot. And that's what I would like to have. So we're going to do that here. And so I'm thinking about doing, man, I really can't decide. I'm really torn between having this bottom bay here be the first, like the ground dinos bay, or making like another section over here with like a garagey thing coming off the side. And we don't have to actually do it the same size as the rest of this, but we still need a third level up top. I need to put some walls and stuff up there as well. I do love these staircases. They actually are working out really well. And so up here will be a third or second flight bay. And I wonder if I should do like a little thing to get out of the flight bay onto this level and then down to this, thinking that that might be a thing. Because it won't get in the way if I just do one here on the back, on this side. Very, very curious, Gypsy. So I'm going to figure all that out and work it out. And the other thing that I was looking at here, and I feel like it's going to look dumb. I feel like it's going to look dumb. But I was thinking, like, what if I put a ramp off of there? Will it intersect? Oh, it's so close. Intersect with this. Okay, well, it sort of did. Intersect with this ramp. So we've got a ramp like going all the way down. And then when you come up here, you know, you've got this above your noggin. See, it's... Why did you not do what I told you to do? Snap up there. All right, so we've got... Right. So then you'd have like, you know, your cooking and stuff out here. And then you could still get out and down. But then you can go all the way up to the top. I just don't know. It feels weird. It feels like it might be dumb. I'm not sure I like that idea. Kind of blocks the door. These and other things will be figured out. And when I come back, hopefully, we'll have it all done up and we can talk about it. We're back, and I think I've done all the work I'm going to do for today. So this is all that's left over here. Some storage and a crafting station. Bam! It's done for now. I think I'm going to probably end up doing some stuff and changing some things, but right now, this is what we got. This is what we got. So you got out here, we got crafting area. I need to add all of the crafting things here. Obviously, we've got what we're working with. And then I realized that you can use the ramps like ceiling. So I might change these to ramps. I'm not sure. I haven't really decided if I like this look better or this look. But we've got that as well. That's all set up. And if you come in here into the main house area, boom, we've got this little area. I'm not sure exactly how we're going to deck it out. Like I said, I might want to put some of the crafting stuff in here so that I can do some stuff inside. And we got a little like lofty thing with a bed, and I'll put some storage there for certain items. I usually like my extra armor and extra weapons and stuff like that. I'll have like a couple of things near a bed for that in case I die and I come back and I'm like, oh, well, you know, I don't feel like going to get my body. So I'll grab all of the stuff, and it's amazing. So out here, bam, we've got the ground floor. It's got some ramps, up into. I'm leaving Mazfu outside so that he can take care of anything that comes in here and threatens the house. And then we've got our new Golden Beak just hanging out here with Powery Dragon and Rugged Icarus. Yeah, that's right. And so I decided not to do like a stairwell thing here. I'm just going to leave it as is. Oh man, these stairs are being wonky now. And I've got Mazion's Argentavis hanging out here. And then upstairs, what is going on with the stairs? This is weird. I wasn't doing that before. I've got Mazion's Wyvern hanging out. And he kind of doesn't like being up here. He does weird stuff. But I had to leave this 3-tall because he couldn't fit into a 2-tall space. Very upset with you for making that a thing. I wanted to have a little overhang, and now I don't have one. But anyway, the one thing I do want to show you that I fixed, and that I figured out the only way to fix, anytime that I had this problem here that we discussed, I had to fix it. The only way really to fix it is to take them all down. I'll get it eventually. I'm not sure that I'm getting it. There we go. Oh man, we don't have to do it there. We can do it here. So if I get rid of these, I have to get rid of those, and I have to pull the bottom wall and the top wall. I'm going to pull the bottom wall first, or the top one, or it'll fall down when I pull the top wall. And so once you've pulled both of the walls, you can put it back. Which we're going to have to do the entire line first. So we take out all these. I think it was 4 wide, maybe. And then we take out all these, which is the whole process. So this is what you got to do if you have that issue. Because it just keeps wanting to snap to that top wall. And no matter what I did, couldn't fix it. Oh, it was only 3. It was only 3 wide. So get rid of all that crap. Just like that. And you place the wall back down. Bam. And everything should be hunky-dory. You should see it right here as it lines up. So that's all lined up now. I'm going to just put down this stuff, right back down, put the walls back up, and then bam, we're sealed up. It's clean and squeaky. Squeaky clean. So I'm actually pretty excited about the base. I like the way that it's coming out. It's kind of neat. It's different from other designs that I've done in the past. I might want to do another like barn thing over here. I'm not really quite sure. Or I might just extend this area and do some more barny stuff out there. And then have just like my big dinos hanging out in the yard over there on this side. These rocks keep coming back. So these are not foundations. They're not considered foundations. It's kind of a pain in the butt. Not really super psyched about it. I'm going to have to figure out a way to keep this area clean. I would love it if I could keep all this stuff just gone. And I could put down like a foundation every once in a while or something like that. But that looks a little cruddy, you know what I mean? We need like an invisible item you can lay down that acts as a foundation. Wouldn't that be neat? Maybe it could be like a little speck. A little dot. And you could go and pick the dot up if you need to. I don't know. Something. We've got our grill outside. I've got all the meat in my inventory. And I can't put it back in there now, so I'm carrying 1,570 meat. I'm a meat master. I don't know if you knew that. But that's the base, guys. I enjoyed this build. I hope you enjoyed it, too. If you did, make sure you blast the like button. Don't forget to subscribe to Mazion Plays Games. And as always, be excellent to each other. Have a great day. See you later.